Now that we have a livable planet, all that's really left to do is inhabit it. It's time to make life. But life, as we speak, is very far from just simple atoms and molecules. Like, even the simplest single-celled organisms like bacteria have very intricate inner workings that take years of study and work to really fully understand. Was life this complex from the very moment that it was formed? Did highly organized assemblages of molecules suddenly just pop into existence one day? Let's see what science has to say. What's up, Ketchup, and welcome to And I Thank You, our time and space to learn life lessons from lessons about life. To answer the question of how life began, we have to go back to some key points that we learned in previous episodes. So if you haven't watched them, please watch them. One, that the entire universe was initially just energy and a few subatomic particles. Two, that all visible matter is fundamentally made of the same stuff. 3, that the Earth was historically just not a good place to live. So if the entire universe started out from just simple stuff like quarks and leptons and energy, and has thus far progressed to more complex, organized stuff like molecules and eventually larger forms of organized visible matter like stars and planets, wouldn't it make sense for life to sort of follow the same trend? We are part of the universe after all, aren't we? And indeed, there is like just an overwhelming shit ton of evidence suggesting that life came from simple things that slowly became complex and changed over time and changed with the Earth. This change is what we call evolution, change over time. By change, we mean most often an increase in organization and complexity. Something becomes more organized and more complex. To put it into perspective, let us start with the building blocks of life. In the atomic level, all life is mostly made of the atoms carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, and phosphorus, and a few other trace metals. If you clump these atoms together, you get molecules. And there are 4 major groups of molecules that are known as the building blocks of all life on Earth. Amino acids, fatty acids, carbohydrates, and nucleic acids. Believe it or not, these building blocks can be formed from spontaneous chemical reactions that are facilitated by cyclical processes. Remember the biogeochemical cycles? Every time that things move around, chemical reactions take place. And somehow these building blocks of life can be formed from inorganic processes. And thus far, this is where science and all the current evidence and studies are leading us towards. It's what we call chemical evolution. Organic life emerged from inorganic chemistry. So if life came from non-living matter, and if even non-living things can increase in complexity, I mean, think like stardust turning into planets and stars. What makes living things different from non-living things? We draw the very fine line between life and non-life when these non-living building blocks start clumping together, and then they form this bigger structure that can maintain and sustain this type of organization and complexity. The first functional cell. And that is life. It just doesn't become complex and then slowly crumbles away. Like stars. They kind of form and then they eventually die. There's really nothing within a star that keeps it, you know, going. We're made of the same stuff, except that we can sort of keep the stuff that we're made of from falling apart. That's the difference between living and non-living things. Much of the details of when and how exactly non-life turned into life, like the exact mechanisms of how these building blocks got together and formed the first cell, that's still very fuzzy, very muddy, possibly blank pages not really sure about the details, and currently that's like an active part of research. And after the whole fiasco of chemical evolution, eventually biological evolution kicked in, and life slowly but surely became more diverse and more complex. The safest assumption that we can make, based on the evidence that we have gathered so far, is that we all, and by we all mean all living things, share a common ancestor, which was a single-celled microbe. We descended from a microbe. We started out, life on Earth started out as these small, teeny tiny things. Single cells. Some single-celled organisms ate other smaller microbes, but instead of digesting them, they decided to work together as one unit, forming the first eukaryotes. Some of these small microbes found it favorable to just stick together and work as one functional colony, giving rise to multicellular life. Some of these eukaryotes eventually somehow exchanged their DNA, unwittingly inventing sex. And here we are! You see? Simple to complex. As some old Chinese dude once said, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. I can't believe you called me just to say this. I had to get dressed and all of that. My gosh. And in the same way, evolution, change over time in general, is a very long and gradual baby step process. It's not like poof, it became Cocoa Crunch. No, doesn't work that way. Evolution takes a long time. And what can we learn from all of this? It might help to start out simple. The universe started out simple. It was a singularity that eventually spread out, became more complex over time. In any endeavor that you have, you don't have to be overwhelmed. When we see other people that they're like, wow, they're so successful, they're already at that part where things have become very organized and complex. And maybe you want to get there. You can't do that overnight. Take your time, enjoy the process, slowly but surely progress. That's kind of what Mother Nature did, and it has always worked. That's kind of what the universe does. It always works. I am pretty sure there's a bit more room in that little old noggin for a bit more learning. So if you want to learn more about the origin of life, how life came about, a little more details on chemical evolution, the last universe, the common ancestor, whether or not the first single-celled organisms were heterotrophs or autotrophs, theory on multicellular origins, all of that stuff, check out these channels. They're gonna lead you to greater knowledge about our humble beginnings. So kita kits mga bagits, I will see you next time. Inai, thank you.